We continue with another Android device, a Samsung Galaxy A10, with problems on the motherboard. Let's take a look at a small diagnosis. So for that, we are going to work with the Samsung Galaxy A10. First of all, we have to connect our motherboard to a power laboratory supply. In this way, we can check the consumption. As we can see, on the needle, on the bottom part, without pressing the power button, we have an additional consumption. Here we can appreciate it much better. When we connect the battery connector to the power supply, we have a small consumption. This device was worked before in other service center. We can also see how the voltage control circuit is a little twisted and some capacitor is crossed. Right here in this area we have the inputs and outputs of the main PMIC. After measuring continuity in some components, it turns out that the line is in short circuit. To know which side the short circuit is on, it's not necessary to remove the circuit. As the PMIC is a little misplaced, I lift it to remove all the dots. We are going to place this capacitor and this bobbin in the natural position. Using 400 Celsius degrees and 30% there, we can do it without any problems. To know where the short is, we have to remove a bobbin from the line that is in a short circuit. The short circuit is on the right side, which means it's on the output. Now, with the help of the thermal camera, we'll see where the short circuit is. If you have some experience, you'll know where these lines go. So, our short circuit is right under the CPU. To be able to remove the CPU, first of all, we have to remove the resin around it. we can use around 400 Celsius degrees and 80% air. Higher the temperature and the airflow, the faster we remove it. As you can see, the short circuit went away. The problem is the joint of the balls between the CPU and the motherboard, also between the RMI and the CPU.